Motown is well known as one of the most impactful and inspirational record companies of all time. Barry Gordy, the founder and mastermind behind Motown, made sure that the company created a brand and image for his artists that crossed racial barriers. Barry Gordy was born on November 28, 1929 in Detroit, Michigan. Gordy's love for music and songwriting began at the young age of 7. Barry tried different professions such as boxing, songwriting, and even worked at a car assembly line to make extra money. Barry always knew that he wanted a job in music, so he bought and opened a record store. Barry wanted to go farther than his little record store and realized that he could design a music business like the car assembly line he worked at. With an $800 loan from his family, Barry Gordy quit his job and he started Tamla Records and named his storefront Hitsville, USA.
Get a real job. And that's why I went to the Ford Motor Company, Lincoln Mercury plant. And when I was on the assembly line, I started perfecting my skills of writing songs. The factory had this assembly line. And I would see the cars start out with their metal frame and go around the circle. And different stations would put things on there. And they would go out another door, a brand new car. I said, my goodness, I can do this for people.
Barry wanted to make sure Tamla produced a genre of music for the masses and that his artists created music that everyone could enjoy. Not just by blacks or the typical style of music, but he designed music for all people to understand and love. Their sound was soulful, but the lyrics appealed to everyone, black and white. Barry made sure his artists were impeccable from the way they dressed, spoke, and even the way they wore their hair. Barry made sure every artist on his label presented an image of integrity so that they would appeal to diverse cultures and classes. In 1959, Barry opened the doors of Hitsville, USA, in his neighborhood in a house on West Grand Boulevard in Detroit, Michigan. A year later, on April 14, 1960, Barry incorporated his label as Motown Record Corporation, its name a blend of motor and town, which has become the nickname for Detroit. While at an audition looking for talented artists to sign to his record label, Barry met his first artist and now best friend and business partner, Smokey Robinson. Smokey Robinson and his group, The Miracles, were one of the first to sign to Motown. The relationship between Smokey and Barry was one of the greatest friendships ever in the history of the music industry, and their partnership helped to propel Motown into the huge success it became. Their first song, Shop Around, written by Barry and Smokey, sold over 1 million records and brought huge popularity to the label, and with it, new and aspiring artists in 1961. As Smokey and the Miracles continued to work on hit records over the years from 1961 through 1962, new writers and singers were added to the label one by one.
It was Barry and four other people. We were there. And Barry said, we're not going to make black music. We are not going to make black music. We're going to make music. Gonna be music for everybody. We're gonna make music with some great beats and some great stories. And that's gonna be our formula.
Greats like the Jackson 5, Marvin Gaye, The Temptations, Stevie Wonder, The Supremes, and The Marvelettes all came aboard. Berry Gordy had a way of understanding how to make great and compelling music. He was an intelligent businessman and designed a brand that was highly regarded by different cultures with relatable lyrics written and performed by incredible talent.
I was criticized by a lot of black people for having the white people there. He's a traitor. He won't hire black people. I said, what do you mean? Come in, look and see. I got a lot of black people, but I also got white people. It's not about whether you're black or white. Or black. I want to win.
It's green.
No, I got a lot of credit for all that. And sure, I put it together, but these people grew on their own. And at some point, you know, it was not me, it was Magic. And it became a brand.
Thanks to the teenager, the record business is a big, big business.
They marketed Motown as the sound of young America.
Baltimore, NBC, now.
I felt I wanted to do music for all people, and it just turned out that people began feeling it, and black people, white people, Jews, Gentiles, cops, and the robbers, I mean, all loved Motown.
Motown was growing by leaps and bounds, but so were the racial conflicts in America. Segregation, the civil rights movement, riots, hate, and the Vietnam War were all escalating throughout the country in the 60s and early 70s. And everyone in America was being touched by the conflict, including everyone at Motown. Police brutality, racial hate crimes, and slow economic growth had left people hopeless. However, through their lyrics, the artists at Motown continued to bring people together and help them understand how to love one another despite their differences. They also helped bring awareness to the violence happening around the world with songs like What's Going On by Marvin Gaye and You Haven't Done Nothing by Stevie Wonder. These songs have gave people a way to come together to fight common goals. The world may have been divided, but the music from Motown's artists helped to show people that there are things like music that can bring people together.
Growing up, everyone would surround the TV and watch the Ed Sullivan Show. So for us to be on it the first time was big.
It was December 27th, 1964. I was 10 years old, and it was a moment that changed my life.
Come See About Me is sung by these girls here, the Supremes, three youngsters from Detroit. Let's hear it for them.
As the music and the label grew at Motown, so was the world around them. Motown was reaching greater heights as Gordy expanded the original vision of Motown. And in July of 1972, he took Motown from just a record production company to an entertainment company. He took his vision and his artists global as the modern world was becoming more innovative and there was a new outlook flourishing for the talent produced at Motown. Artists such as the Jackson 5, the Supremes, Stevie Wonder, and more were given the opportunity to perform on TV shows, talk shows, and more. This helped to expand the artists' music and Motown as a company. What started in a house in Detroit had now become worldwide. This effort also expanded the sound and talent of black artists to different cultures, creating a new respect for black-owned companies. Motown was more than a company. It was a family and an inspiration to others. Berry Gordy set out to make music that all people could enjoy, music that would bring people together, and music that would help others feel good, and that's certainly what happened. Motown set a tone for the way music should sound, make people feel, and inspire them to come together during a time of so much hate and misunderstanding. Berry Gordy's Motown truly was one of the greatest record labels of all time. They set out to create music with great beats, music for everyone, and gave hope to black artists. Motown helped further the idea of equality and compassion between diverse races and eventually led to change around the world.
I know that there are more similarities in the world in people than differences. And my goal in Motown was to bring those similarities out in music and love, togetherness and trust. People were married to Motown music, they dated to Motown music. Smokey Robinson created a great deal of babies from Motown music.
You really got a hold on me.
You really got a hold on me.
It's entwined into our lives in so many ways.